So carrying on from one of my previous presentations where we did safe isolation of a single phase consumers unit or distribution board in a domestic dwelling, of which we isolated the linked main switch or double pole switch inserted within the tails, we're going to repeat a similar process this time, but ignoring the fact that we have this switch in the tails, which isn't commonplace at the moment in industry. So we've only got the means of isolation that comes within the consumers unit itself, that being the main switch, which again is either a double pole or linked main switch, whichever you want to call it, in order to isolate the consumer unit. So we're going to do our isolation process this time with the main switch. So the board, when we go into it, the tails will be live and the rest of the distribution board or consumer's unit should be isolated. We're going to prove that that is isolated and we're going to secure isolation so we can work on the electrical system. So see how we're going to do that. So we're going to isolate the electrical supply from within the consumer's unit by operating the linked main switch or double pole switch here. But before doing so, again, I'd like to reduce the amount of load that that switch is switching off. So I'm going to turn off some of the circuit breakers within the consumer's unit, the RCCBs, but I want to leave something on to give me a clue that the installation has gone off when I've operated the main switch. So I'm going to leave on, as I did before, a socket outlet circuit, could leave a lighting circuit on, whichever you fancy, just that one circuit. So I know when I de-energize this switch, so I'll go from a closed position to an open position, that I actually see the supply has gone off before I start to remove the consumer unit cover. We wouldn't want to start removing the consumer unit cover if the supply was still on. So let's turn off the appropriate circuit breakers, leaving just the socket outlet circuit on. So socket outlet circuit's gone off. So we need to make sure that we choose the appropriate circuit for it to go back on. So which one is it? It's this one here. See, it comes back on and we turn off the appropriate one there. So we've got the socket circuit left on before we do anything else. Okay, so I'm only going to turn off the main switch now with one circuit energized. I've got my plug-in voltage indicator in and hopefully that will give me a clue that the supply has gone off before I remove the consumer unit itself. So let's operate the switch. You'd walk into the installation now, maybe looking for a light that's gone off, or in this case, our plug-in voltage indicator. I can see it's gone off. It means that I believe the supply has been isolated. However, the top of the switch, the tails coming in, will still be live, but the remainder of the consumer's unit is isolated before I remove the consumer unit cover. So I've removed the consumer unit cover. The linked main switch or double pole switch is isolated. So in other words, it's turned off. And now I believe that the bottom of the switch has isolated everything this side of the consumer's unit. However, the incoming tails at the top are still live, coming in from the supply authorities. We haven't turned those off. So these are live, but the bottom of the switch is isolated. And we need to prove that the bottom of the switch has isolated the consumer's unit before perhaps adding a circuit, removing a circuit, or working on the electrical installation itself. So we're going to prove at the bottom of the switch that we are isolated before we start work. We need to secure isolation if we're going to leave the consumer's unit and work elsewhere in the installation. But as always, I'm going to use my approved voltage indicator. Before using it, I'm going to check it on my proving unit. Then I'm going to start the process of proving that the bottom of the linked main switch or double pole switch is isolated. Before using my approved voltage indicator, I must make sure it's in good working order, that it hasn't failed, it's been sitting in the van for a while or hasn't been used for a while. In order to do so, I'm going to use a proving unit. I'm going to probe my voltage indicator into it and I should see all the lamps illuminate. Therefore, it is in good working order. Therefore, I can now use it to prove the isolation of the distribution board. So we're going to test at the bottom of the linked main or double pole switch here in order to prove we're isolated. We know the tails coming in are live, so it's the bottom of the switch that we're going to prove is dead. As previously stated in my presentation, we're going to probe on in a certain order. We're going to do line neutral first, neutral earth, and then line earth. And we're going to go on to the least dangerous conductor first, off the most dangerous conductor first when we do it. So let's see that sequence once again. So first of all, I'm going to probe onto my neutral. I'll try and keep my hands out of the way, and then onto my line conductor. And hopefully we can see that no lamps have illuminated, so therefore it is isolated. We pull off the line conductor and then off the neutral conductor. Next, I'm going to prove between neutral and the earth bar. So once again, going on the least dangerous conductor first, being the earth bar, and then onto the bottom of the double pole switch, onto the neutral. And once again, no lamps have illuminated, off the most dangerous conductor first, being the neutral, and then off the earth bar. My final test will be between line and the earth bar. Once again, going on the least dangerous one first. So we're onto the earth bar, onto the bottom of the double pole switch onto the line connection. Again, no lamps have illuminated, suggesting there is no electrical supply at this stage. And if I remove the line first and then the earth bar. By carrying out all three stages, we've suggested now that the electrical supply at the bottom of the switch is isolated. However, we still need to go back and prove our voltage indicator because it may have failed at this stage. So we need to put it back into the proving unit in order to suggest that it therefore is in good working order. And we will be happy the fact that we've isolated the distribution board. It may be a case of now that we're going to secure the isolation, maybe in a case of that we're going to work inside the distribution board. We cannot leave the area with the distribution board cover off, so the cover would need to go on if at any stage we walked away from this area. Before we can confirm that we have actually isolated and proved isolation of our consumer's unit, we need to prove that our instrument hasn't failed. So therefore we have to go once again into our proving unit and have all four lamps illuminated, which will suggest then our instrument, in this case the plug-in voltage indicator, is working correctly. So all four lamps illuminate. Therefore, I believe we have isolated the consumer unit and proved isolation of the consumer's unit. I think at this stage it would be good practice if you were adding a circuit, altering where you might have to fill in a minor works or electrical installation certificate, that you then go on and prove the polarity of the supply from the top of the switch, which will be a live test. I've stated how to carry that test out in one of my previous video presentations. So we're going to continue on the safe isolation process. I'm going to secure the isolation of the linked main switch or double pole switch here and reinstate the consumer unit cover. So I've fitted my locking off device to my linked main switch. I've secured it by means of a padlock. Once again, I've used the master lock. I do like the master lock, allowing other trades to come along and use their own padlock and key, which they take away their key, in order that they also have control of the supply being re-energized. So at the moment, the electrical team's the only one working on the installation. Therefore, we've got our padlock in position, our signs in position, and we're going to keep our key in our pocket as we leave the distribution board to go and work on the electrical system. I hope this video has been some help.